Internet Nation. Alex and Ashley here with a special video for you. Or for a select sailor. For a select number of you, I suppose. Today, I'm going to be removing the color from my hair. Or trying to. As you can see, well, it looks very black on... That's a little bit better. It looks very black, but it's a dark green. Dark green. Yes, it's a dark green. There's a mirror right there. And as people with green hair know, it's very difficult to remove green hair or blue hair. It used to be blue. I dyed it with a door by, aquamarine by a door. That's the color that I used to get this color, but I've been dyeing my hair blue for, actually I think it was like blonde when I dyed it. I had stopped dyeing my hair and then all the color went away. So it was just kind of like a light green blonde situation that may show in some of my old videos. But anyway, I digress. I am going to be using a product today, and since there aren't very or kind of any videos on YouTube about removing color from hair from locs specifically, I am making this for you guys. Earlier today, was that today? Yeah, that was totally today. I'd used some Dawn on my hair. They recommend that you use the blue one, specifically for washing locks. I figured I would use it, see how it went, because it usually gets my hair pretty clean. I washed it about 4 or 5 times, and all those times there was still color coming out. It's Dawn times, what's the apple blossom scented one, but you're supposed to use the blue one because that's like the best one or something like that. I'm trying to make sure that there's nothing left in my hair. Those are piece, yeah, all that is what I usually keep in my hair. Now, the only thing that's in there now is, like, an octopus that's kind of... Let me see if I can show you guys. He's kind of... He's part of me now. If he comes out, he's not going in. And we are one, so the octopus is going to be in there for all that. Anywho, I used that stuff earlier, and it lightened my hair a little bit. I mean, not, like... A lot, not like enough for it to matter. My tips are blonde, which always makes me a little happy because that means the dye is coming out. But all 4 to 5 times that I proceeded to do that, there was still... I was trying to see where my battery is at because I'm pretty sure it's gone. I was at like 20% on the train, sorry. I'm very ADD. But let me just put that down. Yes, now it's not bouncing around. Anyhoozle. Well, alright. My phone totally ran out of space. Irony. So, I've returned. And excuse the silence as I'm listening. Because my mom just came home, and I may possibly need to wash my hair periodically, and I thought she was asleep, but guess not. So, if push comes to shove, I'll wash it in the kitchen sink. Yep, yep, yep. Anywhoozle, as I said, I used a Dawn earlier to wash my hair, to try and get the color out. And I did that 4 or 5 times, and each time that kind of resulted in a lot of color coming out. And still greenness. Still very green. Now I want to go to a light brown or dark blonde color. And I do not have that dye right now, which I suppose isn't so bad. My producer has not told me if we are working tomorrow, so I did not find it a necessity to make sure that my hair isn't a whatever color it is after this process. Now, everybody that I've seen, their hair turns blonde, but I'm not sure if that's because they bleached it previously. Oh my goodness. They bleached it previously, or if they lightened it. My hair, if anything, under this is a dirty blonde, maybe? Light brown? I'm not necessarily sure how my hair was before I dyed it blue. I know along my locking process, when I started, it was like red, and then it was brown, and then boom, it was blue. And I have like no pictures beyond like blonde dreads. And those are like baby blonde dreads at like a few months old. So, anyhoozle, getting into it. Excuse me, I keep fixing this because I like to hold the camera very close to my face. I don't even know if you can hear me. But we've already started, so we're going to commit to this. Anyway, before I run out of space again, because I do enjoy looking at myself and talking. The product that I'm using is this stuff. That's very close. Color Intensity Eraser. I went to Ricky's today, and thankfully, the sales associate that I was first approached by, the first sales associate to see me enter the store, had blue hair. So, I figured she would know my stripes, because, you know, she has blue hair. And when you have blue hair, you know the hardships of getting blue out of your hair. So, anyway, she recommended this stuff. So I figured, why not? I don't necessarily want to bleach my hair, because anybody that has locs, well, not anybody that has locs, because I've seen people, like, cut them off and just, I guess that's all you can really do is cut them off. But I've seen people cut them off and, you know, I guess there are the people who have dreads for aesthetically pleasing purposes, and then there are the people who have dreads for, like, well, there are also people who have dreads for religious reasons. Mine kind of fall under the category of religious, somewhat Rastafari reasons. So these are my babies. And my hair is my baby, and they mean a lot to me. So, I've done a lot of research on this product. I've watched like 5 videos right before starting recording this. So, I've seen that this product works relatively quick. We're gonna find out together how it works on locs, because apparently nobody else has thought to share that information and or try the product on their hair. I don't know why people jump to bleach before things like this, but maybe there's a reason, but we're totally not gonna fuck up, because these things are important, and this is like 2 years worth of progress, and you don't get long princess hair by fucking up and cutting your dreads off. Nope. See, it's a lot longer than it was when it first started. Well, the ones in the back are. So, we're like, already there! We've already got long princess hair, but I digress. We are going to start this project. I've got my gloves here, I've got my products here, and I've got a mixing bowl here. So, You basically take this stuff, put it in a bowl. And I'm using a plastic bowl here. I don't know if it's the same as like bleach, where you don't use metal. I even went so far as to remove my metal pendant that I usually wear in my hair. This is Medusa. If anybody wanted to see. They've said that Medusa originally had, I should use gloves for this part. That Medusa originally had locs and not snakes, and that's how the origin started. I hope this is the right, okay, awesome. But, who knows? I also used to wear snakes in my hair, because snakes are cool, especially in your hair. So, yeah. But, they all died. Rest in peace, my snakes. So, I just cut the bag open, and I poured it in this bowl. As you can see, it's kind of like a purple color. That dust just hit me. It's got a very strong smell. Very strong smell. Let's tilt this down. Feeling panda, I guess. That sounds like a fun angle. That seems like a fun angle. I did like 27 minutes of video that I had on my phone. Apparently that wasn't enough. So I poured in the developer, and now I'm mixing it. Yes, with my finger. And I have my hair sectioned into, I guess, 4 sections? 3 sections and 1's. Just loose. So I'm gonna... That smell hit me right in the eye. So I'm gonna try to do this as quick as possible. And we're going to see how it responds, or what happens, I suppose. It's a nice purple color. And I'm going to do this very, I want to say recklessly, but I'm just going to put it on my hair. Most people kind of like do it. I know most things like this are done strand by strand, but if this is going to possibly remove the color from my hair quickly and then get bad for my hair, we're going to have to do this quickly, you know? Especially since my phone has no storage. Which is always fun, you know. And I'm prepared. I'm wearing a disposable shirt. It's an old shirt that belonged to my ex. And his ex stretched it out. And then I put it on Ruben. This guy right here. And then he stretched it out some more. So, obviously, it's the giant shirt now. Perfect for this kind of shenanigans. So now we have a nice creamy consistency. Oh goodness, that smell is strong. We're gonna see how this goes. Yep. I probably should have grabbed my towel before I started doing this. Oh god, that hit me right in the eye. This stuff is strong. I can't even keep my eyes open long enough to look at it. Okay. Now it says not to put it on any hair that isn't processed. Technically all my hair has been dyed. The top is already a light brown, even though I only want to get the green out. Oh damn, I got some on my sheet. I guess if I'm home tomorrow, I'll wash my sheets. This is gonna be very difficult if I can't even look at it. That's one thing, this stuff is very strong. Very strong smell-wise. Found something else in my hair, but I'm not sure if this one comes out. It's an old plug. Old metal plug. Burns my throat. I'm actually getting it deep inside of the locs. I'm squeezing it in. I don't do that with a lot of products, but since I've got my handy dandy Dawn here, which gets right in there into the lock, and the Dawn doesn't leave residue. I figured why not. Plus, I have a black soap shampoo that I use that's really good at getting residue out. Now it's not actual shampoo, some black soap that I put in a shampoo bottle. Just like a little sliver of black soap that I put in a shampoo bottle and filled with water. Once more. But you can kind of see. The color's a lot lighter now. I've had it on my hair for a few minutes. It hasn't been more than like 5 or anything. I walked to the bathroom, washed my gloves, and then walked to the kitchen and then came back here. So this stuff does work relatively fast. I did not put any on my roots. I saw one girl had a really bad reaction to putting it on her scalp. My roots are kind of like light brown, dark brown now, so they didn't really need it. But yeah. There's kind of like a fizzling sound going on right now. That's a little concerning, but I suppose nothing too serious for the time being. I'm gonna wait. It's recommended on the back of the packet that you leave this stuff on for 30 minutes. I'm gonna leave it there until it's blonde, basically. And yeah, I will be back when we get there. Well, my darlings, the deed is done, and I have washed it all out. This is the result. And as you can see, it's a lot lighter than it was before. Very, very patchy, I guess that'd be the right term. I didn't use any up top because that's all just brown. And for the most part, I think it's just brown. I don't think there's anything that I didn't get that wasn't brown. There shouldn't be any green there, but I'll have my best friend check tomorrow when I see her. If I see her, I'm not sure if I'm going to do this again or if I'm going to use a different product. I'm not necessarily sure what to do to get the rest of the green out, but if anybody has any suggestions, put them down below. I will keep watching YouTube videos and doing research and then trying to figure out what to do. Whatever I do, I will let you guys know. Just so you guys know the process that I took to get the stuff out of my hair since I did push it in there, I use Dawn to get it out. And then I shampooed it with Dawn like twice. And then followed that up with my black soap shampoo. And then it wasn't like as dry as people say. Like it wasn't brittle and it didn't feel like I was gonna lose a dread. It just felt like very dry. Like, you know, if you have locs, it's kind of that. This is very dry, but I feel like I can get some significant lockage from this. I don't think I did get any significant lockage from it. If I did, it would show on this one right here, because I did unravel a lot of this lock a while ago to get some dirt out, get some lint out, because I don't like carrying lint in my locks, and I like picking it out for reasons. But anywhoozle, that's not what this is about. And it was very dry after that, not brittle. It didn't feel like anything was gonna snap in half. As you can see, still very strong. And then I used Shea Moisture Intense Conditioning. I totally forgot what it was called, but it's the Shea Moisture Conditioner for moisturizing, I suppose, to add a little softness back. And since, you know, that stuff is conditioner, and locks and conditioner don't really go together, I followed that up with the black soap shampoo to get that stuff out. Now my hair is, you know, averagely dry. Nothing too serious, nothing too spectacular. It's kind of basically back where it started before all of that. And yeah. So I only used one packet of that stuff. I left it on for like maybe half an hour. I watched a few YouTube videos and then realized that I should probably not just eyeball it. So I set an alarm for 15 minutes after like 2 5-minute videos. And then since it was still relatively pretty green and I touched my hair and it didn't feel like it was like really brittle or really dry or really damaged or anything, I left it on for like 10 more minutes. But then I realized that the stuff in my hair didn't really feel, it felt like it had dried out, like it wasn't doing anything, and I wasn't hearing any bubbling, sizzling coming from my hair anymore. So then I went to go shampoo and wash this stuff out. But anyway, this is my video. Hopefully, maybe, possibly, it helps somebody out there. This is a significant difference from what it was before. As you can see, a lot of my tips are yellow, blonde, blondish, and my hair is significantly lighter than it was before. When I used the Dawn and the black soap shampoo, I did still get a lot of blue coming out. So, you know, there's still probably some dye in there. I might follow up with an ABC rinse because that's always been known. I'm pretty sure the first time when I dyed my hair blue before I started dyeing my hair blue again, because there was a while where I said I was gonna not never dye my hair again, but I like color too much. So there was a while where I would do that all the time. ABC rinses. ACV. Apple. Yeah, AC. ACV rinses. And then after some time, there was no color coming out of my hair. But yeah, I'm probably gonna follow up with one, two of those, a few of those. And I've been doing those with rice water to add moisture and grow length and some softness, some anything, you know, just some something. I'm probably not gonna do it with rice water because I don't know. It's been a while since I haven't done it with rice water, and I figure I'm gonna do an old school way. Even though when I do it with rice water, it gets a lot of that. It softens the lint in there, and makes it very easy to pick out. But I'm gonna go the old school way. for once, plus, you know, fermented rice water. Well, fermented rice water with apple cider vinegar. It smells very, very sweet, which is a nice turnaround from apple cider, from fermented rice. Period. That stuff is really terrible. But anyway, I hope this video helped anybody out there with locs. I hope you found this. I hope you found my experience enjoyable, maybe? Helpful? I hope it helps somebody. And till next time, Internet Nation, know that you are loved by me. Goodbye. Have a wonderful night, day, evening, all that jazz.